We can 3D print just about anything these days, from tools and buildings to cells and even food. But that's on Earth, where materials are readily available. What about in space or on the moon? Could we 3D print a lunar base? Let's ask a materials engineer. I'm Alana Bartolini for ESA Education, and joining me today is Advenit Makaya. Advenit, nice to meet you.
Thank you, Elena, for having me. I'm a materials engineer here at ESA, and I will tell you more about 3D printing on the moon.
Advenit, before we get to the big question of whether humans can 3D print on the moon, can you explain how 3D printing works?
So 3D printing is essentially how to make an object layer by layer. So you can think of it as you want to print a toy or you want to print a cup, and you start to think about how it would look like if you slice it in very thin layers. So you would know how each individual layer looks on a sheet of paper, for example. You put that in a computer, and then you feed the 3D printer, the machine, with the material that you want to print. It can be a powder, it can be a wire, it can be a paste, and then the computer will tell your machine how to draw the slice of the part exactly how it should look like. And you repeat it layer after layer. You make sure that the layers are glued properly together. And then slowly you see your 3D printing object being made. So that's how additive manufacturing or 3D printing works.
So do we already use 3D printing in space? How can this additive manufacturing be used in space?
So we are already using 3D printing in space. Not a lot, but it's already starting. For example, on the Ariane rocket, there are parts which have already been launched, parts of the rocket which were made by 3D printing. So that's something we know how to do. And here at ESA, we are working on parts of satellites which are made by 3D printing and which will be launched soon. So 3D printing in space will be a reality. 3D printing on Earth is something that we know relatively well. You can buy a 3D printer for your own house. You can play around, make some toys and so on. And if you've ever taken a plane, some parts of the planes are now 3D printed. So that's something that we know how to do. On the International Space Station, we actually have a 3D printer. We, ESA, have launched one about 4 years ago, but it went back to Earth, and NASA has a 3D printer permanently on the ISS. So the astronauts, the idea is that whenever they need something, something breaks, they can have it made directly on the station.
And how do you think we can extend 3D printing to the moon?
The idea is, if you go to the moon and you are going there to stay, if you build a moon camp, at some point you will need to manufacture things. At some point things will break or you need to replace things. So rather than waiting for the next rocket to bring you your supplies, you could actually manufacture them on demand when and wherever you want on the moon. So that's how we are thinking about using 3D printing. And 3D printing really could be used to support anything on the moon, from the structure to build the walls of your habitat, down to the tools that you use, cups, screws, forks, and so on. And we even have techniques to 3D print food.
Can you tell me a little bit more about 3D printing food?
Yeah, so 3D printing food is about the idea of mixing all the ingredients into a big box, and then it flows through a tube, and you can give it the shape that you want. So you can print cookies, you can print pasta, you can even print fake vegetables out of different ingredients, different things that you mix together. So that's quite important for the astronauts because they will need some variety, different things to eat every day of the week. And they only have a limited number of ingredients that they can use. So we can make funny shapes, we can make funny colors, so that their life is a bit nicer up there.
So speaking of these kind of innovative ideas, what's the coolest thing that you've ever 3D printed?
So the coolest thing I have 3D printed, or I've made 3D printed in one of my activities in ESA, is probably this little astronaut, which was 3D printed using the lunar soil, the dust that you find on the moon. And you can get very fine shapes, so that's pretty cute. We have also 3D printed cookies, so that's, I haven't tested them, But that's something.
Hopefully not out of the lunar soil.
Not totally lunar soil. But that's something pretty cool as well. And that just tells you the possibilities that 3D printing offers to make life a bit nicer on the moon.
And how did you get interested and start working in materials engineering?
So when I was at uni, I didn't really know what to do. But what I knew is that I like to understand how things are made, how they work, how do you make them. And slowly I've grown an interest for materials. And I decided to spend most of my time working on that.
Thank you for joining me today, Advenit.
Thank you, Elena.
Stay tuned for our next episode to learn about living on the moon.